Hello, how are you today?
Hey everybody.
Hope you're having an awesome day so far. And today we just want to share a little bit of an update on how the time blocking is going. So for those of you who've been following us, you've probably seen that we are really working on our calendars and our schedules right now and trying to really time block. And so if you're new to our Facebook Lives, just a super quick introduction. We are Josh and Heather Glaze, and we teach and train network marketers how to grow their business online. And we are especially passionate about healthy eating. So we share healthy recipes as well. And so this has been, time blocking has been something that we have wanted to do for almost a year now. Crazy as that is.
Actually, we knew we were supposed to be doing it.
That's right.
We just hadn't done it, you know, the whole getting into action thing.
Yes, so. And we struggled because this isn't the first time I've attempted it. Hey, Dorothy, how are you? And so we actually... time blocking and car driving. Yes, we are on our way home from a networking, not really a networking.
No,
that was more of a mastermind group. We have a couple people that we are really working closely with right now. And so it was an awesome, awesome time. We're making plans. But one of the reasons that it's happening is because it is on our calendar and we are scheduling that time. And I can tell you from experience, I have tried this before several months ago. I tried, but I didn't do the whole thing. I just tried to put a couple things on my calendar and it didn't work. It didn't last. So this time we did it different. And if you're curious to learn more about it, you can reach out to us and ask, or you could search the videos, because we did do a video a week or two ago about how we started in the beginning, because I think that is what made a huge difference this time around, don't you?
Yep,
because
I think so.
We really broke it down and we had big post-its or big papers, and we put post-it notes all over it, and we like really figured out, what do we need to do? We just did a huge brain dump and brainstormed, and then we took all those things and we put them in our calendar, whether it needed to be done daily or monthly, weekly, whatever it might be. And this is our first actual week of doing it, actually living out, to live out our schedule. And I can tell you so far, my biggest struggle is going to bed so that I can get up and actually do the stuff I need to do first thing in the morning. And then, let's see, you know, one thing we've learned is that just because you've got it all in your calendar, it doesn't have to be, you know, I think one of the reasons I avoided it in the beginning is it feels so strict. It's so rigid. And I am... Yeah, Josh is very much that way. Josh loves a plan. He very much loves that kind of stuff. I'm really fly by the seat of my pants kind of person. You know, I'm going to do whatever. And he's totally laughing, but he knows it's true. Isn't it?
Absolutely.
I'm going to do whatever I feel like doing when I feel like that's just the way I am. And so this has been really challenging for me to try and break it down and say, okay, this is in my calendar and I'm going to stick with it. So I think I was kind of scared to do it. I felt like it would be really, really hard. And instead, it's been freeing. It's been weird.
Yeah.
Totally weird. But I think it's because the things are no longer just in my brain. You know, that to-do list, I'm bad. I don't even make to-do lists. It's all in my brain. And it drives him crazy. But that's what I've always done. And it worked for me, kind of. And so now the fact that it's like on my calendar, it's out of my brain. And so I'm not thinking about the little things. I don't have to think about, oh, did I feed my kids lunch? Did I help my youngest? I still help her with her lunch. And, you know, some of the little stuff. She doesn't now come to me later and go, Mommy, you forgot to do my lunch. You know, so that has been huge for us. Hey, Kim, how are you? And so, you know, so far it is the first week and we are learning a lot. We definitely... One of the biggest things that I think is helping, if you want to start this and you're brand new to time blocking, is at the end of the day, every single day, we have in our calendar to review our calendar, and you know, we talk about it, and that way we can actually see, okay, what worked, what didn't work, you know, is there something we need to move around? And so we definitely have found some things this week. One thing, we had meal planning on Sunday night, which I thought would be fine. We meal planned and I love that. We figured out exactly what we were eating each day this week. But then we realized that, oh, Sunday night's not a good time for that. We really need to put it on like Saturday morning so that we could go to the grocery store on Saturday or Sunday, because then we struggled to figure out, where are we gonna go to the grocery store this week? Because our daughter ended up with an ear infection and life happened and we didn't get to go. And so Josh ended up going late at night instead. So we're gonna move that. So we figured out, you know, that that needed to be moved. So that was huge. And just little things like that that we're learning. And yeah, it's really helping.
Yeah, so just reflection. And if you ever listen to John Maxwell, he talks about the law of reflection. And it's just in general, yes, taking time to reflect on what happened in your day. What did you learn?
Yeah.
What experiences did you have? How can you use those things? You know, what did you need to learn? What do you need to change from the things you learned? And so that's a key part of that, is just reflecting on your day and then looking at the next, you know, looking ahead too. But, and you have to look at your schedule as a guideline. That's, mm-hmm, that's like, you know, Heather said, it can feel almost constricting, you know, like, oh, I've got to do these things. But you have to look at it as a guideline and know that you've at least got it mapped out and you know the stuff's on there that needs to get done. But it doesn't have to be. And then that's the whole point of, you have to leave some white space in there too, because things are going to run long.
Right.
You're going to get held up. Different things are going to happen. And you have to be able to, you know, move things around a little bit. Or you may need to move something, say one day that needed to get done, you got to move that to another day. And that's part, mm-hmm, of that reflection at the end of the day.
Yeah. So we're going to keep on, and we're just going to keep reflecting every night and making those changes as we figure out what they need to be. And I feel like, you know, in a couple weeks, we'll have a good feel for this. And then we'll keep you guys up to date on how it's working and the difference it actually makes in our business. And so I'm excited to share those things with you in the future weeks. So we hope you guys have an awesome day. Thanks so much for hopping on, everybody. We hope you have a great day. And I will be back in the kitchen tomorrow with a healthy recipe. So you guys have an awesome rest of your day. And we'll see you tomorrow.
See you.
Bye, guys.